Welcome to Snake's Top 5. Today, we're diving into a three-way battle between land, air, and sea. In one corner, we have the notorious cobra, known for its hood and deadly bite. In another, the infamous killer bee, whose swarms strike fear into many. And lastly, the deceptively beautiful bluebottle jellyfish, terror of the oceans. Which of these venomous creatures packs the deadliest punch? Let's break it down. We'll be analyzing each creature's venom across five categories. Toxicity. How potent is the venom? Venom yield. How much venom can they deliver in a single encounter? Delivery mechanism. How effectively can they inject their venom? Speed of action. How quickly does the venom take effect? Treatment difficulty. How challenging is it to treat envenomation? Annual human fatalities. How many human deaths does this species cause each year? Each category will be scored out of 10, with a maximum total of 60 points. The highest score will be crowned the deadliest of the three. Cobra venom is highly potent, containing a mix of neurotoxins and cytotoxins. The neurotoxins attack the nervous system, potentially causing respiratory failure, while cytotoxins destroy tissue. Some cobra species, like the king cobra, have venom so potent that a single bite can kill an elephant. Cobras can deliver a substantial amount of venom in a single bite. An average cobra can inject about 200 to 500 milligrams of venom per bite. The king cobra, the largest venomous snake, can deliver up to 7 milliliters of venom, enough to kill 20 people or even an elephant. Cobras have an efficient venom delivery system with hollow, fixed fangs at the front of their mouth. However, they don't always inject venom when they bite, sometimes delivering dry bites. This defensive behavior slightly reduces their score in this category. Cobra venom acts relatively quickly. Symptoms can begin within minutes, with severe cases leading to death within 30 minutes to 2 hours if left untreated. However, in many cases, it may take several hours for severe symptoms to develop. Treating cobra bites is challenging. It requires specific antivenoms, which may not always be readily available, especially in rural areas. The combination of neurotoxic and cytotoxic effects also complicates treatment. However, with prompt and proper medical care, many victims can survive. Cobras, as part of the larger group of venomous snakes, contribute significantly to global snake bite mortality. According to the World Health Organization, snake bites cause 81,000 to 138,000 deaths annually worldwide. While specific data for cobra-caused fatalities is challenging to isolate, they are a major contributor to this number, especially in Asia. In India alone, where cobras are one of the big four venomous snakes, an estimated 46,000 people die from snake bites each year. Given their wide distribution and frequent encounters with humans, cobras likely cause thousands of deaths annually, warranting a high score in this category. Individual killer bee venom is actually less toxic than that of regular honeybees. However, what makes them deadly is the sheer number of stings victims typically receive. Their venom contains melanin, which destroys cell membranes, and phospholipase A, which triggers pain receptors. While a single bee doesn't produce much venom, killer bees attack in swarms. Victims often receive hundreds or even thousands of stings, leading to a massive cumulative dose of venom. This group attack strategy significantly increases their effective venom yield. Killer bees have a highly effective delivery mechanism. Their barbed stingers pump venom continuously, even if the bee is brushed away. Moreover, when a bee stings, it releases pheromones that attract other bees to join the attack, ensuring multiple stings. The effects of killer bee stings are usually felt immediately, with intense pain and swelling. Severe reactions can occur within minutes, especially in allergic individuals. However, in non-allergic victims, life-threatening symptoms from mass envenomation may take longer to develop. Treatment for killer bee attacks can be challenging, especially in cases of mass envenomation. While basic first aid involves removing stingers quickly, severe cases may require intensive supportive care. There's no specific anti-venom, but antihistamines and epinephrine may be used for allergic reactions. Killer bees, while certainly dangerous, cause fewer annual fatalities compared to snakes or jellyfish. Accurate global statistics are difficult to obtain, but we can look at data from areas where killer bees are prevalent. In the United States, where killer bees have spread since their introduction in the 1950s, bee and wasp stings, including, but not limited to killer bees, cause an average of 62 deaths per year, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. In Central and South America, where killer bees are more common, fatalities are higher, but still relatively low compared to other venomous animals. Estimates suggest a few hundred deaths per year globally, which, while significant, is lower than cobra-related fatalities. Bluebottle jellyfish, also known as Portuguese man-of-war, have potent venom. It contains a mix of proteins and peptides that cause intense pain and can potentially lead to cardiovascular collapse. While rarely fatal to humans, their sting is extremely painful and can cause systemic effects. Bluebottles have numerous tentacles, each lined with thousands of stinging cells called nematocysts. A single encounter can result in multiple stings, delivering a substantial amount of venom. Their long tentacles, which can extend up to 30 meters, increase the likelihood of extensive contact. The bluebottle's delivery mechanism is highly efficient. Their nematocysts fire upon the slightest touch, injecting venom through tiny harpoon-like structures. Even dead specimens washed up on shore can sting, as the nematocysts remain active for some time after death. The effects of bluebottle stings are almost instantaneous. Victims experience immediate intense pain, described as feeling like being branded with a hot iron. Systemic effects, if they occur, can develop rapidly, potentially leading to cardiovascular issues within minutes. While most bluebottle stings can be treated with basic first aid, severe cases can be challenging. There's no anti-venom, and treatment is mainly supportive. The pain can be difficult to manage, and in rare severe cases, cardiovascular support may be necessary. The risk of secondary drowning also complicates treatment in ocean encounters. Bluebottle jellyfish, despite their painful sting, cause relatively few human fatalities each year. According to the U.S. National Science Foundation, all species of jellyfish combine cause about 40 human deaths annually worldwide. Bluebottle jellyfish account for only a portion of these. In Australia, where bluebottles are common, they are responsible for more stings than any other marine animal, with tens of thousands of stings reported each year. However, fatalities are rare. The Australian Resuscitation Council reports that there have been no confirmed human deaths solely attributed to bluebottle stings in Australian waters. Globally, bluebottle-related deaths are estimated to be in the single digits annually, mainly due to secondary drowning or severe allergic reactions. After tallying up the scores, we have a clear winner. The cobra takes the top spot with 49 out of 60 points, while the killer bee and bluebottle jellyfish tie for second place with 44 points each. The cobra's high score reflects its potent venom and the serious threat it poses in a single encounter. The bluebottle matches the score with its lightning-fast, painful stings and the potential for extensive envenomation. The killer bee remains a formidable threat due to its swarming behavior and efficient venom delivery. As always, the best way to stay safe is to avoid encounters with these creatures altogether. Education, awareness, and respect for wildlife are key to coexisting safely with these fascinating but potentially dangerous animals. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, and we'll see you next time for more exciting comparisons of nature's most potent toxins.